show.
It's a big race. The Shy's on the blue nexus. KT's a threat. Who's going to win? The Shy will not. KT takes it to game four.
Holy
It's that world where legends will fall and new ones will be.
Have you guys seen eSports and the E-League?
I don't know if that's sports.
But it's great.
I have not seen it, Ernest.
I have seen it.
I had zero knowledge of the fact that this exists.
You didn't know there were cyber athletes?
My hand to God, I didn't know there were cyber athletes. But my issue is it's still not a sport.
Well,
it's a game. Am I following what I'm saying here, Bernie?
I do. Do you have any statistics on how many of those people... also go to Star Trek conventions?
I would guess there's actually a fair amount of overlap, actually.
YouTube launched a new video network yesterday where you can watch other people play video games. For real, the whole network, it's called the We Should All Be Very Ashamed of Ourselves for Failing as Parents channel. Actually, it's called YouTube Gaming, and I don't get that. To me, you know, watching another person play video games is like going to a restaurant and having someone eat your food for you. Just if you like them, play them.
I am not a friend of esports, okay?
Why are you so against? I just don't understand.
Well, it's the same with professional wrestling. It's for booger eaters.
Boutong. 자는 시간 이외에는 최대한 연습을 하려고 하고요. 보통은 하루에 12시간이 기본이고요. 이제 좀 대회가 얼마 남지 않았다거나 좀 중요한 대회가 남았을 때는 15시간 이상 연습하기도.
I think about what it took for me to become a professional athlete. Took
right.
a lot of concentration,
yeah.
a lot of dedication, practice, preparation,
right.
stamina.
Esports is probably the number one growing competitive scene out right now, and more people are watching it every single day. And if it's something that you're interested in, I think you follow along. The commentators are unbelievable. The preparation that they have, the production that they have, it's really fascinating. I've been there. I've been to where they shoot everything, and you know, they sell out stadiums.
Do you think that people don't respect how difficult it is to play competitive video games? Because
yeah, definitely. I mean,
it's fucking really difficult. Like the level of competence or the level of skill.
Question I'll get a lot is, how do people pay money to watch other kids play video games? And it's a funny question because those are the same people who will pay money to watch someone play baseball, and yet they don't put it together. And if you bring them to the studio, they instantly get it and there are no follow-up questions. Being in the environment and creating an environment that is very hype, very lively, very authentic to the feeling of sports in general, we find is a high priority for our events team.
More than 12 million people attended live esports events in the U.S. and Western Europe in 2014.
In August of 2013, Riot Games sold out the Staples Center in Los Angeles in 1 hour.
I'm Avia Sharp-Zapor that are coming to you live from the Staples Center here in Los Angeles, California.
The story made headlines in publications across the world. People were finally beginning to realize that the hidden world of esports was far bigger than they could have ever imagined. If Kimmel and Coward had bothered to look, they would have found that the viewership numbers for the 2015 League of Legends World Championships alone could tell a compelling story about exactly how big esports had grown to be around the world. That year, over 36 million unique viewers would tune in to watch a Faker-led SK Telecom T1 take home the trophy.
America's first ever college scholarship team for, brace yourselves, video games.
We were able to recruit some very, very good players. Some of our top players are rated in the 0.02% of all players in North America.
Yes. Athletic scholarships for video gamers. It's just the latest signal that so-called esports have arrived.
If I wasn't a pro, I'm not actually sure what I'd be doing. I got really tired of school. It wasn't something I could do consistently. It was just too boring for me. I didn't really have any other motivation to do anything else, I think. So I don't actually know what I'd be doing. I'd probably be like, I'd end up on the street or something like that.
For player turned caster Joshua Leisman, being able to make a living doing what he loves is a vindication.
Basically, if you played a whole bunch of games, it was what are you doing with your life? And why are you playing so many games? Go focus on something else. Whereas now, there's the beginning of it being thought of as a career or something that you could actually accomplish. It's kind of a dream, just like being a professional hockey player, a professional basketball player.